Hey everyone, summer is coming, so that means it's time to get out and have some fun. Cleveland Recreation invites you to play by registering for any of our baseball, swimming, and junior golf programs. Baseball programs are available for youths ages 4 through 19. The basic fundamentals of the game are taught, and youths progress through various levels, ultimately participating in the Connie Mack League. If you would rather create a project of your own or express yourself through performing and visual arts, the Division of Recreation offers arts, crafts, ceramic programs, and show wagon performances. So come celebrate summer fun. Don't miss out on the free lunch program, summer camp, soapbox derby racing, and a host of other special events. You may even have the opportunity to celebrate an Indians victory in person at Progressive Field. Don't let summer pass you by. Visit one of our 20 recreation centers, 25 supervised playgrounds, 19 indoor pools, and 22 outdoor pools, and have yourself the best summer ever in the city of Cleveland.
What a spring season it was. The rain came, it poured, and we were saturated. But here we get to Championship Day from Cleveland State University Viking Field for the championship game in the Cleveland Metropolitan Schools, where the Rhodes Rams will take on the John Marshall Lady Lawyers. Hi, I'm Tim Wells, and my special guest announcer is Olivia Wolfhope. And Olivia, when you talk about these two teams, they come in here with some pretty good information. Let's talk first about the Rhodes team.
So for the Rhodes, they were the 2016 defending champions. Their last playoff win was they got one in a 15-0 win over John Hay, and then their season record overall was 7-2.
And then on the other side, the Lady Marshall Lawyers, their only loss was to Rhodes, but it was an overwhelming loss at that.
Yes, and then their playoff win that they had was a 19-2 win over JFK.
Well, we have all the teams here, and we're going to talk more about the teams. But right now, we're going to go over to Edwin Santiago for the player introductions. Ed?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Cleveland State University's Viking Field for the CMSD Softball Championship game. Today, between John Marshall's Lady Lawyers and James Rhodes' Lady Rams. Introducing the Lady Lawyers. Playing first base, wearing number 7, Rochelle Bradley. Second base, number 3, Patrice Thomas. The shortstop's number 4, Kayla Sheyfelt. Playing third base, wearing number 21, Tatiana De Jesus. Doing the catching is number 8, Destiny Shahi. Doing the pitching, number 24, Allison Wilshire. Playing center field, number 10, Yaritza Felix. Left field's number 5, Sierra Shellhorse. Playing right field, wearing number 6, Carolina Ramirez. Wearing number 9, Malaya Harper. Wearing number 14, Masara Alzarir. Number 23, Linnea Howard. Introducing James F. Rhodes, Lady Rams. Playing third base, wearing number 3, Shakira Marrero. Playing first base, wearing number 10, Miranda Franks. The shortstop is number 15, Ashley Colon. Number 16, doing the catching, Genesis Morales. Doing the pitching, number 20, Kaylee Metro. Center field is number 1, Mary Fragua. Playing second base, number 4, Tiffany Vlock. Number 17 is left fielder, Vanessa Lombardi. Right fielder, number 7, TJ Benson. Outfielder, number 2, Heidi Valenzuela. Outfielder, number 5, Sydney Vega. First baseman, number 6, Beyonce O'Neill. We're number 8, third baseman, Hope Hartman. Number 9 is an outfielder, Sonia Butrago. Number 11, outfielder, Brianna Fulkerson. Outfielder, number 13, Brenda Bermudez. We're number 14, shortstop, Brianna Vasquez. Outfielder, number 18, Tiana Hernandez. We're number 19, first baseman, Annalise Metro. Outfielder, number 22, Mariah Saratsky. Number 23 is an outfielder, Alexi Nieves. At this time, we ask that you rise and remove your caps for the playing of our national anthem.
As you can see, we are moments away from championship action to the Cleveland Metropolitan Schools girls fast pitch game. First, we're going to take a look at the officials that are going to be calling today's game. And Olivia, tell us about them.
Yeah, so behind plate, we'll have Mike Hall, who came from Cleveland Central Catholic. He's been an umpire for 10 years, and he works for the Berea City Schools Transportation Department. Out behind first base, we'll have Colin Robertson, who came from Father Flanagan's Boys Home in Boys Town. He's been an umpire for 34 years and is retired. And then behind third base, we'll have Sue Shermer, who came from Finneytown High School, University of Cincinnati, 25 years as an umpire, and is also retired.
Outstanding group of umpires will call today's game, and they're all certified through the Ohio High School Athletic Association. And obviously, when you're talking about some outstanding players, it starts with the John Marshall key players. And again, all of these have been selected as league all-stars. And again, you're looking at a team that comes in with 6 seniors, 1 junior, 2 sophomores. But it starts with their first baseman, Rochelle Bradley. She's number 7. She's on the left. Athletic MVP, their MVP, leadoff batter, straight A student. In the middle, Tatiana DeJesus, 4-year starting, good all-around player. Plays in the summer, so she loves the game. And on the right, Destiny Sheehy. She stepped up to play catcher, first time ever. She's been an outfielder, but a great team player and a pleasure to coach. And then when you look on the other side, you're talking about a veteran team. Defending champs, they bring them all back, and they also pick up one person coming in that can dominate the game from the mound. And you look at their key players, it starts with their shortstop, number 15, Ashley Cologne. Again, Ashley is the league MVP in 2016. She also can dominate with the good plays, and she's one of their leaders. Shakira Morrow in the middle. She's a leadoff hitter, a captain, solid hitter, strong arm with great defense over at third. And again, Genesis Morales, we saw her a year ago. Power hitter, blocks the ball, but a strong arm. And the big thing that's more improved than anything from a year ago, she definitely will throw some runners out. So as we get ready to start, let's talk first real quick about the Rhodes defense. How do they line up, Olivia?
So up on the mound, we have number 3, Kaylee Metro. Behind the plate, we have number 4, Genesis Morales. At first base, you have number 10, Miranda Franks. At second base, number 4, Tiffany Velach. Shortstop, number 15, Ashley Cologne. Third base, Shakira Marrero. Out in left field, you have number 17, Vanessa Lombardi. Out in center field, number 1, Mary Fraga. And then in right field, you have number 7, Taha Benson.
So leading off is Rochelle Bradley for the John Marshall Lawyers. And she immediately puts the ball in play, and it hits the gap. This may go all the way to the fence. She's rounding second, coming into third. The throw, no throw, and she starts off with a 3-base hit. And again, Rochelle Bradley showing that, hey, it's just a matter of getting the bat on the ball. And the last time they met, this young lady threw the no-hitter at him, but not today. 60 degrees, sunny skies. And again, when you're looking at first inning of pitcher, pitches high, what is that, nerves? A little bit anxious?
Yeah, a little bit of her wild pitching maybe at the beginning with the high ball could be some nerves, or maybe that's just where they swung at the pitches when they met last time and played.
And one of the things when we talked to the coach from John Marshall before the game, she had told me she wanted to make sure her kids got good swings at good pitches. So 2 strikes, she's ahead. Line drive right to first. Oh, they're gonna double her up. They do. Come on. You talk about mental mistakes. You're a coach. Tell us, what are you telling that player if you're the third base coach?
You know, that's one of those ones that's a hard, because it was a hard, quick hit straight back to that first base, but you got to take a little bit of a shorter lead when the ball's in the air like that.
So 2 down, and now it's up to Kayla Schanfeld, their shortstop. You know, we had a chance before the games today. We talked to each player about, hey, what do you want to be in the future? And you look at Kayla, she loves the softball, but she's planning on being a model down the road. It's interesting to see some of the things they've talked about. And we'll talk about them as we go through the day. Fouls it off. And you can see the John Marshall team is up there swinging at them. They're doing a good job. So she'll strike them out. But they get 1 hit, no runs. And again, the Rhodes Rams will come up to bat. And when you look at the Rhodes starting lineup for today, again, all seniors, all returners, except for 1 new one that transferred in, the pitcher. So leading off will be Shakira Morrow playing third base. Miranda Franks will bat second, hitting 316 over at first. Ashley Cologne. She's so exciting to watch, a lot of enthusiasm. The shortstop, 556. Kayla Metro, the transfer in pitcher, 444. Mary Fragua, the center fielder. Tiffany Velach over at second base. Vanessa Lombardi over in left. And Tasia Benson, the right fielder, rounds it out. But on the defensive side, and they're going to have to play it today, John Marshall, let's talk about them.
Yep, so they're going to have to play tight defense today. In the circle, you have number 24, Allison Wildhire. Behind the plate with her, you have number 8, Destiny Sheehy. At first base, we have number 7, Rochelle Bradley. At second base, number 3, Patrice Thomas. At shortstop, number 4, Kayla Shellhorse. At third base, number 21, Tatiana DeJesus. In left field, you have number 23, Lene Howard. In center field, we have number 10, Yuritza Felix. And then rounding it out in right field, you have number 6, Carolina Ramirez.
And again, those are the starters defensively for the John Marshall Lawyers. But more importantly, the pitcher is going to have to throw strikes. And when you talk about the keys to the game, when you talk to the Rhodes coach, he said, hey, we just need to put the ball in play and minimize our errors. And again, when you're talking about fast pitch softball, relatively new to the Cleveland area, it's been played in a lot of independent leagues, but the Cleveland schools, they had the biggest challenge this year in spring sports more than ever before. And I've never come into a game where you're looking at a team playing 7 or 6 games for the regulars. They've had so many rainouts. I mean, it's been like one monsoon after another, and now to come in here and try to play in a championship, that's going to be tough.
Yeah, it gets tough, especially towards the end of the season when you have a bunch of games getting canceled and you have to practice instead. Like, a lot of these kids are gamers, and when it's game time, they're ready to go.
So leading off for the Rhodes team is number 3, Shakir Moraro. You see where she, what she wants to be later in life there?
Yeah.
FBI agent, folks. Takes one inside. She's had 6 RBIs, scored 11 runs for her team during the season. Honor roll student over at Rhodes. And one way up and high. And again, you can tell that the young lady here, Allison Wilshire, pitching, you can tell she's just beginning to learn the game. Ground ball. Third baseman over, nice play. A nice job by the third baseman. Again, that was Tatiana DeJesus over to Rochelle Bradley, and you look at it here.
Yeah, that's a really nice play. I really liked how when she fielded the ball, she kept running towards that base instead of stopping her momentum. That really helped her get that extra out there.
So one down, and now it's gonna be Miranda Franks, the first baseman, hitting 316 on the year. She wants to be a cosmetologist. Again, another honor roll student over at Rhodes. And folks, we want to remind you as we go through today that next week, TV 20 will be over at Progressive Field, where the Rhodes Rams will defend a title again in the baseball, and they'll be taking on the John Hay Hornets. So keep tabs on TV 20. Foul and back. Two-one count, one down. Cleveland State University. Viking Field, you're watching the Rhodes Lady Rams taking on the Lady Lawyers from John Marshall. And you talk about the coaches on the one side. Tell us about Sarah Copeland, the coach from John Marshall.
Yeah, so this is her first year as the head coach. She's been around as the assistant with Lori Hine, and then she coached in the Emerald Necklace League. She's also been a teacher for 20 years. She had her first championship appearance, and then she was also a graduate of John Hancock High School. She played at the University of Morris, Minnesota.
Ashley Cologne, they're gonna run right away. And they hesitated backing up. Now there's gonna be a throw back to the pitcher. So she'll move all the way over to third base. So the Rhodes Rams don't hesitate with the speed. So Miranda Franks, that is her eighth stolen base on the year. Fly ball right field. Oh! No good. And standing at second base is Ashley Colon. So now it's Genesis Morales, the catcher. She led the team with hits this year. Line drive, second base. So no hesitation, she lines out on the first pitch, making it two down. And now it's Kaylee Metro. Eight hits on the season, five RBIs. John Marshall fouled it back. And I can tell you this, Olivia, if we were here right now talking to Cal Long, he'd be smiling. He just wish he'd had a few more of these days in April where we could play some more games.
No, yes.
Ground ball down the line. This will be at least one. She's going to try for two. And she'll go in standing with a two-base hit. Oh, my. So now batting for the Rhodes is Mary Fragua. And what's she looking to do in her career?
She's looking to join the Army after she's done with high school.
Two and oh. You know, we were talking about Sarah Copeland at the end of the inning. We'll talk a little bit about the Rhodes coach at the end of this inning. She's been around the plate for the most part, gave up a couple. Swings 3-0, fouls it off down the first baseline. First base camera guy got a little sun over there. Want to let him know it's safe to swim. He's by you now, you're good. TV 20 coming in your house. Here from Cleveland State Viking Field. Olivia Wolfhoop, and for you folks at home, I'm gonna have her tell a little bit about yourself. This game of girls fast pitch, it's kind of caught on. You're like in love with it right now.
Yeah, I grew up playing in Wellington, and then I actually came and played my career at Cleveland State. And then now I am a college coach at Oakland College, and I'm also a softball coordinator for Cleveland Baseball Federation.
So we draw the walk, and now Tiffany Velach is up, the second baseman. So you've played on this field.
Yep, a lot of memories have been made.
Oh, I can imagine. And good ones at that. So former Cleveland State Viking player. I guess your biggest challenge is going to be this summer. You know, trying to help the girls get along, to learn the skills. What are you trying to do as we'll catch that right after this pitch. Up high.
Yeah, so this summer what we're looking to do is implement softball youth development camps for all kids in the city of Cleveland, just to help them get a better grip on some of the skills and some of the tactical sides of the game. There actually is going to be one this Saturday at Estabrook Recreation from 12 to 2 with the Akron Racers.
Ground ball, base hit up the middle. They'll get it in, and she'll come in, and two more runs will score. And Rhodes is on a roll. So now it's up to Vanessa Lombardi. You've pitched in this game. How many times do you see those heartbreak ground balls get through the infield? Yeah. What does it feel like when you're pitching, you see that happen?
It doesn't always feel good, you know, because you're working hard in that circle, trying to do the best you can for your team. But it's one of those things where sometimes you're going to make mistakes. You're going to walk people. You're going to give up a nice big hit. So when your defense does let a nice ground ball go through, you just got to make sure you pick them up just as if they would pick you up.
So they'll get her on the strikeout. But in that inning, they come up with 4 runs on 3 hits, 2 hits, and we also had 2 walks that added to it. So again, as we mentioned earlier, Olivia, when we get a chance, we're going to talk about the Rhodes coach. And Jack Wipke, let's talk first about the Rhodes coach.
John Wipke, this is his second year as the head coach, and he was an assistant coach at Max Hayes. He's a graduate from Holy Name, where he played football, and then he also attended Cleveland State University.
Well, while we're here at Cleveland State University, our special thanks has to go out to the university. They've been such a gracious host the last number of years for the girls to play here. But also, right now on the mound they're warming up is the MVP of the 2017 season, Kayla Metro. And we caught up with the head coach from Rhodes to get his views about his MVP.
Kaylee Metro was our league MVP this year. Really blessed to have her. She came out for our team first year as a senior. Had a great season. Led by example, always positive, picked the girls up, threw 2 perfect games in the course of the year, and we're just really happy to have her. I wish we could have had her a few more years, but she was a wonderful addition to our team this year.
Well, I'll tell you what, this girl's going to be around for a long time. If the Cleveland State coach is around, better tell her to hold off. She's still got to get out of school this year. Strikeout, they're going to make the throw, and a good job by the catcher, Genesis Morales. You know what really makes me feel good is that you've seen Rhodes play here a number of years now, and the development of the players, the coaches from Rhodes have done a tremendous job teaching and developing them. And also, I think the kids playing a little bit during the summer season with the RBI program has helped. And we do want to send word out to you folks that are watching this. There is a girls fast pitch league. It's free to all Cleveland residents. So if you're interested, you can pick up the phone. And I'm going to give you that number. Ground ball to the second baseman, Tiffany Vallach. Over to Miranda Franks. Solid defense. I can remember when Tiffany just started playing. She was a nervous young kid, you know. But now she's got it like a pro.
Yeah, and a lot of that would go back to those coaches helping them learn all those fundamentals so that when they do get out on that field, they're as confident as they can be.
Our hats have to go off to the coaches for the time that they've spent in working with the kids and making sure. The Rhodes Rams, they're going to try to repeat. As long as you got a pitcher like this, this makes every coach look smart, right?
You're correct.
Ground ball. Tiffany over to first. And again, they're getting the swings on the ball. But three up, three down. They had one strikeout where it's been all the Rhodes Rams so far here in the bottom of the second inning. Again, our folks, we want to let you know that our special thanks has to go out to Cleveland State University, Cleveland Indian Charities, TV20, Cleveland Clinic Sports and Health Awareness, all the coaches and the city of Cleveland and all the supporters. Got a pretty good crowd here for a nice day. Come out and see the kids play. And again, John Marshall, as much as we look at him today, you got to believe that this coach that's working is going to be teaching and developing as they go. And, you know, Sarah Copeland, she may be the first-year coach as a head coach, but she's been around this game for over 20 years. You know, whether it's in the Emerald Necklace League or it was with Lori Hine, the former icon coach from John Marshall. So two good coaches today in the championship game. And we're also going to be showing you next inning the league champions of the Cleveland Metropolitan School District that had championship years in the various sports. It's been a great year for Cleveland Metropolitan Schools, able to give the kids an opportunity to participate. The same time, we always keep in mind student athlete. When you're a college coach now, what advice do you give to the kids you see out here?
I mean, part of my biggest advice is that it's a student athlete. Therefore, you're a student before you're an athlete. You know, that's why you're in school. You're there to get your degree. But I think being a part of an athletics program does keep you on a good schedule. It does keep you motivated. And I think it's something that if anyone's interested in, that they should look into going after.
So bottom of the second, 4-0 Rhodes. Leading off is Taja Benson, the right fielder. Hits a ground ball, foul. I'll tell you one thing, if these kids would have had about another 7 or 8 games to play during the year, you could see the improvement that would take place.
Yeah, I think that would have helped them a lot, or give them a lot of more things to look forward to, especially with practicing. You can practice so many skills as much, but there's a lot of game-like situations that you develop the skills for during the season.
Spring sports is always one of those in Cleveland where you say, man, I hope we get a dry spring, you know. And it's tough. I mean, you know, the kids come and they practice and game day comes and the rain's flying out there. What a play! Oh, my! The first baseman from John Marshall. Down on her knees, comes up with it. A great play by Rochelle Bradley. I'll tell you, a lot of pride here. So one down, we're back to the top of the order. Shakira Moraro, her last time up. She grounded out to third. A nice play by the third baseman, Tatiana DeJesus. And she'll draw the walk. Now, Miranda Frank, she walked her last time out. And she moved up on the third. up high. Take one up high. That's not a good sign when you're missing up high there.
No, yeah, that's one of those easy ones that you could just put right over somebody's head if the batter keeps their hands high and drive all the way through.
Not a good sign. So John Marshall. Now batting is number 15, Ashley Colon. She hit it to right last time. And a nice catch on the pop-up. She'll get it in. So that's two down.
Come on, two down, let's go.
And now it's going to be Genesis Morales, and she lined out to the second baseman. You look at it here, you got to give her credit the way she played that, Olivia.
Yeah, she definitely made the correct play on that, and then she also had the reaction time to get the ball right back to first base. She did a great job on that play.
What do you think the toughest part of the fast pitch game is to teach the young girls?
I think the biggest, hardest part to teach is like pitching, because there's just so many different components about it, whether it's what type of pitches you're throwing or the mechanics of it. On an offensive standpoint, I mean, I think hitting can be hard when it comes to teaching the kids and what you want them to do each time they're up to bat.
So now coming up to bat is the pitcher, Kaylee Metro. And as if you found out, she is the league most valuable player this year. Hey, you're throwing two perfect games, no hitters. Coach is going to go out and check on her player over at second base to make sure she's okay. Okay. Again, you're looking at Sarah Copeland, and there is our league MVP. Two perfect games, add a no-hitter to it. That's a pretty good year for anybody.
Yeah, she's a good example of one of those pitchers that when she is throwing, she does a great job of keeping the ball low, and then she also adds that curveball movement that I really think fools those hitters sometimes.
We got to find out what school she's thinking about going to. I wonder if it's Cleveland State.
The coach could only hope so.
Yeah. You know, the Rhodes Rams, the Lady Rams, they were coached by Miss Tuma for years. And they were so blessed to have an outstanding coach. And Jack Whipke was fortunate enough to pick the ball up and keep it going for them.
Yeah, a lot of these teams are so lucky to have so many coaches that are so knowledgeable about the game and so passionate that all they want to do is make them get better.
Fly ball, way back, all the way to the fence. One run will score, two runs will score, and they're cleared on a two-base hit and three RBIs. Well, I guess she just showed us, huh?
Yeah, so that's one of those ones when we just were talking about keeping those pitches low. That was a high pitch that she kept her hands high and drove all the way through and got that nice double hit.
So she showed she can not only pitch but hit the ball as well. Although you don't want to get it up in the wheelhouse, and that's what they did. So now we're looking at number one, Mary Fragrance. She walked her first time up. So the Rhodes Rams look like they're en route to a run spread game. We'll find out what that is in due time. So one ball, two strikes. She's ahead, two outs. Foul that one off. Pop up, first base. Oh! When you see that kind of a play, and I don't know if they'll show the replay or where she dropped it, but it definitely looked like she had a hard time picking it up. So they pick up another run. So an error on the first baseman. Line drive in the gap. This will go all the way to the fence. She'll hit second. She's going to try for third. She'll come in standing up before they get it back in. So a three base hit. You look at it right here.
Yeah, that was a good example of a nice swing. She took her hand straight to that ball and she stayed level all the way through.
So now, it looks like we got a pinch hitter up. It looks like number 19, Annalise Metro. I wonder if she's any relation to Caitlin. You'd have to think so. And again, when you're talking about an honor roll student and a career, what's her career? What is she looking to do?
Yeah, after school, she's looking to school to be a pediatrician. So that's one of those ones where if she's going to go be a student athlete, she's definitely going to put her academics before the sport.
You know how when you're real young, you say, well, you know, I remember when I was a little kid, I'd say, I'm going to be a cop. Or I'm going to be a lawyer. I'm going to, you know. Two strikes ahead of the hitter. Two and two. Outside ball four. So number five is coming to hit for number seven. And that's Sydney Vega. She's a merit roll student. She's had eight runs scored during the season. I like her future. She picks the right one.
Yeah.
So now coming into pinch hit here is number five. Wants to get into business. Right down Broadway. Right Again, a beautiful sunny day. You couldn't ask for better weather. Ground ball, third. Oh, no, right through the rickets. And the floodgates have opened here. So first and second, now batting is Shakira Moraro. And Shakira, in her two times up, she has walked. And she hit a ball shot right at the shortstop. I don't think there's much you can, you know, do in a situation like this. You know, your pitcher's getting it over. So now it's Ashley Colon coming up. She's reached on an error and popped out to second. And one of the concerns, I think, going into the game for the John Marshall was we need to minimize those mistakes. Play the defense only getting three outs, and you can see right now that has definitely not happened.
Yeah, that's one of those things where from your pitcher, the most you can ask for is for them to throw strikes and then to have that defense to help back you up.
So all you do is you keep going out there throwing strikes and hope they're going to come through here and make a play for you. Ground ball, shortstop. Oh, not again! So now batting is Ashley Colon. She lined out and was hit by a pitch. So she's lined out to second, hit by a pitch. It'll take one up high. Count, two down. It'll take one outside. No place to put her. The bases are loaded. Pitching, pitching, pitching. What really makes it bad is that your pitcher can be throwing strikes, and if they don't play the defense, then it just snowballs on you, and that's what we have going on right now.
Yeah, this is one of those times where, like, you just need your defense to just make that one more out, get you out of this inning, and then try and get your bats going.
So we're looking at Genesis Morales. She has lined out the second, and she's also been hit by a pitch. And you can see right here, a lot of stuff up high, a lot of pitches. First pitch strikes. I don't know what we got with first pitch strikes. Total of eight. And that's not a good sign. And oh my, the last thing we needed. Kayla Metro, one more time. She cleared them last time. She doubled twice, four RBIs. Wow. Foul ball. So you can see the Rhodes team way out in front. They're going to foul this one in foul territory. Foul ball. So again, 0-2, she's been ahead. Again, Olivia, when you're in this situation and you're the coach on the losing end, there's not much you can say to your kids. In this situation.
No, this is when you look to those senior leaders or even a junior leader if you have one. And this is when you look to them to find that spark or that energy that that team needs to pick themselves up, come up to bat, and get some runs.
Well, listen, tell me a little bit about your Cleveland State career. How did it go? Who did you play for?
No, it was good. Yeah, when I was here, I played under Becky Norris. I was a pitcher. I played in 2013. Through 2015.
And you have any records at the school?
No.
No? All right. I figured, you know, what the heck? We got Kayla setting records on this field right now.
Now maybe if she comes here, she'll set the new records.
Sure looks like it. And she's not even a freshman in college. She's throwing with good speed. Back to the fence. On the triple. Here comes a throw. Oh, my. Somebody got napping. I think they might have had her.
Yeah, I think that's one of those plays that you got to stay alert the whole entire time that ball's in play, because there's potential that you could have made that play and got that out.
How many RBIs is that, Coach? Seven? We might have to check the record books, see if we've had seven RBIs. Ground ball. And it is finally over. As again, Mary Fragwick grounds out to the second baseman. And again, you're looking at a lot of runs and a lot of mistakes combined to a score that you're looking at right now. Folks, we'll be right back with some more Cleveland Metropolitan Schools Fast Pitch Softball.
It's that time again. Time to register your kids for summer camp at George L. Forbes. You must be a City of Cleveland resident between the ages of 9 and 13 and available for one free week of summer camp June through August. To register, bring proof of residency, age, and guardianship, up-to-date immunization records, and a copy of a physical to any City of Cleveland Recreation Center. For more info, call Camp Forbes at 216-263-5325. Again, that's 216-263-5325. And I'll see you at George L. Forbes this summer.
Welcome back to Cleveland State University Viking Field, where the Rhodes Rams have been on a roll all day long, not only with an outstanding pitcher, but some hitting, but they've had a little bit of help on the John Marshall side as the young ladies they're getting the bat on the ball. But defense has hurt them. And again, this young lady here, if she isn't college bound, somebody sees this, they will have her going college bound.
Yeah, no, especially with a pitcher like this. She hits her spots and she keeps the ball low. And that's a lot of things that a lot of coaches are looking for when they're looking for a pitcher to add to their staff.
So one down. Again, we looked at number 23. That was Lene Howard. And now we're looking at number 10, Yuritsa Felix. She likes singing. She wants to be an actress. Fouls one. Foul territory down the first baseline. Round ball. You can tell the more they swing, the closer they're getting to really putting it in play, but they're still way behind. I mean, I can remember when I was a coach and they'd have a dominating pitcher that was overpowering. Just swing early, I'd tell them. There it is. She get it in there. Rounds out to Tiffany Vlock. Over to the first baseman, number 6 from Rhodes, and that is Beyonce O'Neill. So two down. And again, their run spread mutually agreed by the coaches was going to be 15 runs after the third inning. So we're at the third. If they don't score here, this will do it. Gonna try to lay down a bunt, and she's on. I think they got everything but the ball on that
right.
One.
That was a smart heads-up play by the batter. You know, if they're making contact lately, they've been hitting it straight to the player, so that was a smart move by her to try and play the short ball.
I used to bunt when they were there. If I can't hit you, maybe I can bunt it on.
Still got the ball in play and got on base, so it's all that matters.
So now, batting is top of the order, Rochelle Bradley. She made a fantastic play in this game. Sings that one up high. Draws this one back into the crowd. I got a youngster over there. I don't think that kid can't be more than one, if that. Looked like he was going to reach out and grab it.
I was like, he was out there ready to catch
that
ball.
He's ready to go. Takes one down low. What a two. Two out. And Kayla Metro would like to wrap it up right here. And she fouled that one back. Man, is she firing it in there. I wonder how fast that is right now.
I don't know. If I had to guess, she's probably throwing somewhere in the upper 50s.
I bet you if your choice, you'd be recruiting her for Oberlin.
I know, if I had my choice.
Every time I see Coach Douglas, you know, during the summer, he's always talking pitching. They had a pretty good year over at Mount Union this year.
Yes, they did.
How did Oberlin do? They do okay?
Good. Last year their record was 2-35, and this year we went to 14-28, so you really couldn't ask for a better season than that. Progress.
Swing and a miss, and that'll do it. That'll wrap it up here. As again, the Rhodes Rams have dominated and won today. So folks, stay with us, because when we come back, we'll be at midfield with both teams right after this timeout.
Hey everyone, summer is coming, so that means it's time to get out and have some fun. Cleveland Recreation invites you to play by registering for any of our baseball, swimming, and junior golf programs. Baseball programs are available for youths ages 4 through 19. The basic fundamentals of the game are taught, and youths progress through various levels, ultimately participating in the Connie Mack League. If you would rather create a project of your own or express yourself through performing and visual arts, the Division of Recreation offers arts, crafts, ceramic programs, and show wagon performances. So come celebrate summer fun. Don't miss out on the free lunch program, summer camp, soapbox derby racing, and a host of other special events. You may even have the opportunity to celebrate an Indians victory in person at Progressive Field. Don't let summer pass you by. Visit one of our 20 recreation centers, 25 supervised playgrounds, 19 indoor pools, and 22 outdoor pools, and have yourself the best summer ever in the city of Cleveland.
Welcome back to Cleveland State University Viking Field, where you've been watching the Cleveland Metropolitan School District's Girls Fast Pitch Championship game between the Rhodes Lady Rams and the Lady Lawyers from John Marshall. Sarah, obviously you came in here with one thought. If my kids can get some good swings, put the bat on the ball, that did happen. But you also said we've got to play some defense because they're going to put it in play. That kind of hurt you today.
Yeah, obviously. You know, Rhodes, they're the real deal. You know, pitch, hit, run. I mean, they did a great job. Kaylee Metro, there's a reason she's the MVP.
Well, you could see as the game went on, you're right, she definitely was the real deal. But I was really impressed with the way your kids played in a lot of ways. It won't go down in a stat book, but I was looking at one of the plays that I thought was one of the best plays of the game, Rochelle Bradley, the first baseman. What a great play over at first base that they're going to give you the gold glove.
Thank you. I was just looking at it like it's the championship game. We got to play to win. Like, if you wanted something, you had to play like you wanted it. And it's like in the second inning, when they tend to score runs on us, everybody broke down. And it's just like, I was trying to keep everybody up, and everybody, even in the dugout, fighting against each other. That's not what we.
Okay. Well, first of all, let's bring in Dr. Long. He's got a special presentation. Doctor? All right.
Thank you, Tim. Appreciate it. Sister Sarah. Fantastic job. How many didn't? We want to take this opportunity to let you know what we look at from the athletic department. We don't look at wins. Understand that. We look at sportsmanship. And these are two of the best teams with sportsmanship. So I want to commend you on that, ladies. You and the Lady Rams as well. So, Coach, and to your fans, thank you. You're very supportive. We appreciate that as well. To your parents, we present you with Sarah, Coach, and to the Lady Lawyers. Thank you much.
Well, once again, congratulations to the Lady Lawyers for making it here. But right now, we're going to go over to the other side and meet our city champion.
Welcome back to Cleveland State University, where you've watched the championship game between John Marshall and Rhodes, and we're with their head coach, Jack Wipke. And Jack, you've kind of had a little prize to deal with for a couple years.
Yeah, but it's real easy with this group of girls, hardworking, show up every day, and always wanting to get better.
You know, when you look at your team, and we can look back at history, but I gotta believe there was a record set on this field by a young lady by the name of Metro who pitched here today. And then to come up with 8 or 9 RBIs, most pitchers aren't expected to hit, but she sure proved it all today.
Oh, yeah, she did. I've been waiting on it. I know she's got a good bat and came up with some great opportunities, bases loaded twice in that inning there, and she delivered.
Well, right now we're going to bring in Cal Long for a special presentation.
Thank you, Tim. Appreciate the opportunity. Ladies, you're great. You're fantastic. Good job. So who's this Metro? Where's Metro?
Right here.
I know. I was just kidding. No, let me extend my congratulations to the Rhodes, Lady Rams. How many is this in a row now?
Too many to count.
Okay, that's a good start. But let me congratulate you on a job well done. Just like I told the ladies on the other side, you have such good sportsmanship. You're always smiling. And that's a good thing. But, hey, fantastic job. Good job you did today with the hitting and the pitching and all the other things. Really appreciate it. And to the fans also, the Rhodes fans, congratulations to you. We appreciate you as well. Thank you. So we take this opportunity to present this trophy to you, the Senate League Softball Champions 2016-2017. Congratulations, ladies.
Well, as you can see, the Rhodes Rams not only will take pride in becoming the defending champs one more time, but as we talked about, it was domination from the word go. It was totally a team effort. And Olivia, when you look at this team, there's a lot of players, they talk about what they're going to do with the future, but I know there's a lot of these players could go on and be very special at the college level.
Yeah, so with this team, they proved that they could play this solid defense. You guys proved that you could pitch. You had a great catcher behind you. I know she was helping you probably the whole entire season. She did a fantastic job. Everyone played defense and everybody hit when they needed to, and that's the most important factor.
Well, you've been watching championship action from Cleveland State University. Again, congratulations to the Rhodes Rams. But before we leave, we want to remind you that next week we'll be at Progressive Field. Can the Rhodes Rams repeat one more time in baseball? But for this day, we're going to look at some of the faces, some of the great plays that were part of the 2017 championship game. So for Olivia, I'm Tim Wells. Thanks for being part of TV20. Good night, everyone.